the 1990s, I spent 15 years documenting the design and evolution of Malayan and Singapore shophouses built from 1900 to 1957. It was during the British colonial period. 3 years ago, in 2018, I was commissioned to do a painting of a shop lot along Jalan Puru Lama in the heart of Kuala Lumpur. I had to quickly brush up my painting skills again because I have not been painting for many years. First, I take many photos of the building to use as references. Then I draw up the shape and all the details in pencil before I start painting. What interested me most was the rich mix of the Eastern and Western architectural motifs found on the streets of Penang, Malacca, Singapore, and Kuala Lumpur. I was also drawn to the local communities who lived and worked there that give this place its unique character, colour, and charm. We must not forget the brutal and exploitative colonial rule at that time. The British brought in slave wage labourers from India and China to work in the tin and rubber industry. Malaya became the world's largest exporter of tin and rubber. All the wealth went back to the city of London. What little the local merchants could scrape together financially, they managed to build double-story townhouses like these, using local bricks, tiles, and wood. The earliest structures were small, single-story, made mainly of timber, bamboo, and palm leaves thatched roof. This building, with the date on top of this facade, is over 100 years old. It reminds us of how the early migrants survived their hardship. In the 18th, 19th, and 20th centuries, the British and other European invaders dominated a large part of the world to extract wealth and natural resources using their military might. One of the legacies of that period was the introduction of the European architectural style. It was the revival of the ancient Greek and Roman classical architecture. We can see on many streets buildings with pilasters, big and small, imitating the Greek columns. Also notice the rounded arches of windows, doorways, and walkways copying the Romans. There are triangular and semicircular pediments on rooflines, windows following the Italian Palladio fashion. The large Chinese population also brought along their traditional architectural motifs, and they freely added it to the design of their homes. Here are some Chinese religious and cultural symbols on the roofline. Back to the watercolour painting at hand. I enjoyed the process of getting all the lines, shapes, and colors to come together as an artwork. The roof line of this typical colonial facade has a balustrade with green ceramic balusters in the shape of vases that were popular. In the middle of this balustrade, there is a pediment with a semicircular top with a small floral decoration. Below it is the date that this building was built. The date is important as it marks the beginning of the British Malaya becoming the world's largest exporter of tin and rubber in the 1920s. This part is the pitch roof covered with interlocking tiles. I take pleasure in getting the details of the arrangement and also to make it colourful. Next is the load-bearing wall that also acts as a firebreaker in case of fire. The wet colours running into each other is to give it a weathered look, which contributes to the charm of this building and also to this painting. Looking at the photograph, I notice that the present window with its row of patterned ventilation brick above the metal window frame didn't quite fit into the space. The window designs from the neighbours could give us a clue to the traditional construction. So I took the liberty to change the design in the artwork with a wooden casement window with a flat arch fan light. The strong colours used in the 5-foot way in the front of this house suggest heavy pedestrian traffic. This public space provides the much-needed shelter from the sun and the rain. There is usually a wooden plaque on top of the main door of many Chinese families' home with their surname on it. This tradition has its roots in ancient China. The wooden main door is made up of two layers. The inner one is a double-leaf panel door that is shut at night. The outer sliding timber bar door is closed in the daytime for safety and also allows for ventilation and to watch the world go by. This door is a distinctive Chinese architectural feature made by nameless skilled craftsmen and craftswoman. There are two large wooden windows with vertical bars for security on either side of the main door. This arrangement gives the facade a balanced symmetry and its iconic look. The finishing artistic touches of this traditional structure are the two air vents in the shape of a stylized bat placed above each window. To the Chinese family, this is a symbol of good fortune and well-being. I'm glad to complete a portrait of this townhouse after an absence of painting for many years. This experience brings back memories from 30 years ago. At that time, many of these historical architectural heritage were being demolished, abandoned, and built over. Sadly, this is still happening in many towns and cities today. This collection of 64 artworks is an attempt to underline the survival and to also give me and others an opportunity to revisit our childhood homes.